prices. Brought to you by Hudepohl, the pride of Cincinnati brewing tradition, and Hudy Delight, the light brew from Hudepohl. Now, for Jack Moran, here's John Popovich.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to BPA King of Bowling here on Channel 9. And today we're at Kingpin Lanes on Beachmont Avenue. And as you can see, I'm not Jack Moran. My name's John Popovich. Jack's feeling a little under the weather, so I'll be doing my best to try to fill in for Jack this afternoon. Now let's take a look at who our bowlers are today. First of all, our top qualifier is John Gant, who rolled a 757 1 week ago. John will be going against Bob Goodwin, who is the runner-up in the qualifying with a 742. Dave Newrapp is our third bowler with a 721 in qualifying. And our current champion, Steve Fair. The low in qualifying was a 612, and there were 497 entries. Helping me out, especially in Jack's absence, Sammy Coleman, and our guest commentator, Mats DeFelice. And we'll be right back with today's bowling right after this message.
Well, here we go for our final game of the day, and a couple of heavyweights here. You're looking at Steve Fair, our defending champ, and he'll be going against John Gant, who just defeated Bob Goodwin. Well, what do you say about it, Jumbo? This caliber. This fellow here has done it all at the age of 25. He's got many, many more years to really be a top bowler in the country. Could a Gant be intimidated by someone like a Steve Fair?
One thing about Steve Fair is... See John throw this ball.
Super. Matches it all for ball.
John is not what you would call an old timer in tournament play or television play, where Steve Fair is. He's been in all situations. When you talk about two ABC titles, state titles, city title, it's going to be pretty tough to intimidate Mr. Steve Fair, because he has a tremendous concentration factor. Here's Gant.
Okay. Now that was a bowling ball. That was a bowling ball. That just creamed those pins.
He throws a bomb, I'll tell you that. Our score marker is Phil Mascarella down there, and Stevie Lee's going to leave for the U.S. Open this afternoon at 5:15 to fly to Houston, Texas, full of big Texas lanes. Other bowlers are Don Scudder, George Klein, Kevin Johnson. Kevin Gillette will be there on the Pro Tour.
John, I think we have a match here. I think so. Two frames in, nothing but strikes. Solid balls. Mats, I noticed Steve stands at that line longer than the other three bowlers that we've seen this afternoon. I talked to Steve about this in the past, and he says, well, Mats, I just have to be ready mentally. My feet, fingers in a ball, everything has to be so that when I get to the line, I can execute, and I cannot do it unless I do take that amount of time. So we're all different. Some go fast, some go slow. Had to wait on that one. That was the first time Steve threw on that 29 lane. So with the results of that, he just might make a little move the next time he bowls on it. We're riding five straight strikes.
We've had some previous champions here. Carl Compton's bowled on this pair. Hank Hepps. Dickie Freeman was the latest. Shoot 749 for three games here.
Gant looking for the third straight. Just a little bit high.
We got Don and Mary Cucci, who win the state doubles title here. They go to Reno, Nevada to bowl for $50,000 first prize with expenses paid. It's going to be a beautiful tournament, I'll tell you that.
John Gaines. Didn't want it that close, but if you notice, John Gant finishes at the foul line, he's stiff-legged, and that's where John gets all his power. That's his leverage point. And most of the times, that ball is close to his ankle or close to the side of his body as he's going through with a ball, which gives him the leverage that gives the pins and the roll on the ball the action that his throwing and rolling power gives him. Steve will be bent at the line with his knee and he'll be extended beyond the foul line, lifting the ball over the line in the neighborhood of 18 to 24 inches. Steve can adjust that very easily. Does he have to throw it forward? Does he lay it down? Whatever he has the capability of doing. See that concentration. I don't think you have to say anything when you see a strike like that, John.
Well, Monty's Stevie's very solid at the foul line. Throws a super ball. He's been through the mill many a time, and he's cool. Really a cool cookie, I'll tell you that.
He really don't know what's going on around him a lot of times when he's bowling. He's that way even in league where it's just a fun thing. But he's very serious, and I've seen him practice and throw 30, 40, 50 balls, and he don't know anybody's around. And if you want to become a champion, that's the responsibility you have when you practice. Short. So that breaks a string. I made mention, call, that he threw on that lane before, and it was a little high. And actually, that was his second ball he threw, and this is his third on 29, but he was a little high on that other pitch. Possibly, he allowed a little bit more than he wanted to, and wound up with a 2-4-5-8. Leaves himself open. The ball just did not make a high enough hit on the two-pin to carry. And Motz, we're going to be right back with this championship game right after this. So Steve Fair sits down to think about that open frame for a few moments while John Gant bowls. John rolled his high series yesterday up at Delfair Lanes, 8-14. There's an example of a power shooter. Pin comes off the sideboard, comes and gets one of the pins that would have been a split. Power shooters do have advantage to knock more pins off than a soft or the medium speed bowler. Saved himself some unnecessary trouble there. Now looking for the seven, and he gets it. Speed with revs is what you're looking for. Speed without revs, the ball goes through the 1-3 or the 1-2, and it won't carry anything. So if you're going to throw speed, you're going to make sure that you stay under the ball long enough and get the rolls on the ball. John carries an average of 203. He's been in this game about 10 years now. Tough break. Pocket hit. As good as he could throw it, but a little heavy. This is a makeable split. John's got the ball that can do it. It's a matter of executing the shots that he does make. He'll go cross alley. away. You try to hold that hook back, if you notice. Do the ball a little slower.
But technically, you know, Stevie's up about 19 pins right now at the moment, John. I think you'll make the correction after that dinner bucket you missed.
There in the sixth. Yeah, that's it.
John, don't make too many mistakes, John. He'll make it, but he'll correct quickly.
Mm-hmm.
He knows all facets of the bowling game. He knows equipment. He knows lane conditions. So fair is in the ball game at all times.
I imagine that may make him very effective as a pro. We've been talking about his summer, fall. He plans to go on the pro tour. You have to adjust each new house.
If there's anybody in Encino, Cincinnati to make it on a pro tour, I would justly say that Steve Fair is capable.
He leaves the seventh standing. There's so much mental attitude to sports, especially at bowling, because you're all by yourself. You get no help. It's you, and whatever your performance is, you will get paid off. And Steve has a tremendous concentration point.
Unusual. John, we have a question every week. The question this week, who is the junior king of TV bowling last year? Junior king of TV bowling last year. The question last week, who was the queen of bowling? That was Dottie Wagner, who won it back-to-back 2 years in a row. And the qualifier next Saturday will be starting at 8 o'clock over at Walt Centerland. We'll see Pete and Dottie Wagner there. 8 o'clock we start.
John Gant would like to get in this game now. John, he's got to throw strikes.
There's one. That's advantage. Seldom see Steve Fair give you those opportunities to get in a game like
unbelievable.
That. Yeah, when you leave the door open, here they come.
You know, one-on-one, anybody can beat anybody. Your past history don't have much bearing on what's happening out here on the lanes today.
Again, Steve Fair, our defending champ, John Gant, our high qualifier.
We'll see if John Gant should win. Then Don Newkirk would get on if he would win. See, John would be a high qualifier from yesterday. He really was, he'd be the king. Then Don Newkirk would move into the fourth spot then. And so you can tell who Don Newkirk is rooting for.
You can rest sure that Steve Fair knows what he has to do here. Shot again. So we really got what, Sam? 3 pins difference here?
3-pin spread.
John Gant on top.
And also in the crowd is Dave Newkirk, who won it 10 times here. He's in the crowd today. 10 successive weeks he was on. That's the record. Davey Hines had 9 and Don Scudder had 7. And this is a must ball here, I'll tell you this.
Wait. Boy, he does take time.
But he does the job.
Shot with a little light, but being a power bowler, he had the pins coming off the sideboards. You use everything you can use to get strikes.
Yeah, that's what you call answering the call. Now, this is another must strike. We're getting done where they're getting automatic.
During the week, I was hoping for this kind of match between these two power shooters because it had to prove to be interesting.
And it is interesting. So, John Gant has a problem here. Not a major one. John Gant is actually behind now.
Well, technically, that puts Davey Fair up by 9.
Again, we have 2 pins. Hoping he makes the spare. And he does. John Gant looks like an athlete. Very much he enjoys racquetball. Of course, we said he's a baseball pitcher. Well put together. Very strong.
Johnny studying to be a doctor, so you should be able to operate on these lanes pretty good.
Well, he had it there, John, but again, just a trifle high. And John's best shot is when it's light. He shakes it, gets a little bit too high in the pocket. He'll leave at 6. And like a 4-pin for a right-hander, what we have to do here is just make this barren. Hope your opponent. And he doesn't as we finish the 9th frame.
You know, that's all she wrote.
All game's over, it looks like. Stevie Fair shouldn't have any trouble. He's about, 2 pins, possibly? But he'll be shooting for a strike.
He doesn't even need a mark, really.
Doesn't need a marker, Sam. I just
don't even need a mark.
I need a couple pins, I believe.
So you get an awful bad count.
He'll be close.
Close enough.
Close enough.
I'll take that close anytime.
Well, that's a pressure bowler, I'll tell you that.
Now, you see at the 9th frame, John, where Stevie got that 2nd strike when he had been behind. Now, that's what you call competitive toughness. That's where a fella gets him when he needs him. And to put the pressure on John Gant to have to throw a strike in the 10th, as many as he strikes as he could throw, put the pressure back on to Stevie Fair. But just so happened he threw a good shot. But he had a spare and missed it. That was the ball game. This don't mean nothing. He's won the match. He'll be on next week again. So will Gant, by the way, but he'll be in a high qualifier, right, Sam?
Right. With a fill on these 3, Stevie gets 219, and John Gant had 191.
So when we get to the championship game next week, we can see the same 2 guys back together. Steve Fair, again, is our king of bowling with the 219 to John Gant's 191. We'll be back right after this.
Steve Fair, our king of bowling again this week with a 219 in that final game over John Gant. Mats DeFelice here to present the checks for us today. Mats.
Fine, John. Thank you. First, we're going to give a check to David Newrath. Dave feels that possibly if he had used another ball
and some brains,
and he says some brains, he might have bowled a little better. Bob Goodwin feels that possibly if he had any speed today, he could probably have gotten the ball over the line much further and possibly a better score. But we appreciate your talents here today.
And some brains.
And some brains. John Gant. What can we say? Mr. Revs, enjoyed your show. Nothing can we say. It would be so great. Here's the greatest bowler, folks, in the world, and we wish him good luck in the U.S. Open next week with the rest of the gentlemen from Cincinnati.
Before we'll leave, I'd like to announce our winner. The question last week, who is the queen of bowling? Answer, Dottie Wagner. Mrs. Howard Williams of 146 Brookhaven Avenue, and that one right, she'll receive a $50 gift certificate from Carl's Bowler's Paddock. And again, Jack Moran, a little sick this week. We hope he's back next week. We could have the same matchup in the finals. So we'll see you again next week on BPA.